La diffusion vient de démarrer. Tous les participants sont en mode écoute seule.
¿Qué tal? Muy buenas noches tengan todos ustedes. Muchas gracias por conectarse el día de hoy. En esta ocasión tenemos la participación de Ross Hosman, que es director del área de desarrollo de negocios y marketing del Macquarie Graduate School of Management de la Universidad de Macquarie. Y nos va a hablar sobre los programas que existen en management, en MBA, en esta universidad. Estos programas son de gran calidad, de hecho están rankeados dentro de los primeros 50 lugares a nivel mundial. Entonces, Ross Hosman va a platicarnos un poco sobre en qué consisten y también como sobre las opciones de beca que tienen disponibles los estudiantes mexicanos. Entonces, vamos a dar inicio. Hey, Ross, welcome. So, please start.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you all for attending this webinar. We are very pleased to have you. I think we're going to have a few more coming, so I'll start slowly. As I'm not sure if you all can see this first slide. It's entrance to Sydney Harbour. You can see the Harbour Bridge over there. We are somewhere. Our school is about 10 kilometers away from the bridge. Unfortunately, that building on the right, the Opera House, is not our office. We are all the way at the back. Do you all hear me properly? And can you see all the PowerPoint presentation? They can only listen. Okay. So let me tell you. My name is Ross Hosman, as Guadalupe mentioned at the beginning. I'm a director of business development and marketing. Today I have with me my colleagues Diana and Ivana. They are both working with me in the recruitment section. And if you ever decide to get in touch with Macquarie University or with MGSN, they will be a point of contact for you. And they will also be with us for the duration of this presentation to answer any questions that I may not perhaps be able to answer. My background is I joined MGSN a couple of years ago. I spent 20 plus years in investment banking and wealth management all over the world, in Sydney, in the Middle East, Switzerland, London. I've been back last 2, 3 years and working for a few projects at MGSM. One is, and the most important one is the international development. But enough about me and my colleagues. I would start with the school. What's going on? Okay, MGSM was established in 1969. Was the first business school created in New South Wales and Sydney, and it was established on the initiative of Sydney Business Community as an entity to facilitate educational managers in Australia. We have been a first-year business school in Australia since then. We have a very strong corporate connections. Number of our alumni are senior executives, almost very often C-level executives of international and domestic organizations based in Sydney and overseas. We have more than 16,500 of them across 135 countries, so we're very international. Currently, there are students from bit less than 50, or 50 nationalities studying at MGSM. What's important is that all learning is happening on our campus. When the school was established 45 years ago, the campus was purposely built for management education. We're still sitting in that campus. The campus is on the grounds of Macquarie University, but is dedicated to management. That's the place where managers and experts and leaders of corporate world in Australia gather to learn from each other and to network. What's important for the students is this ASCSB accreditation, which is a stamp or proof of quality of a school. I think there are about 17,000 business school or management school globally. About 1,200 of them are accredited by ASCSB. Why is that so important? Firstly, it's important for the students because if you ever decide to go and study management, you go for a school that has ASCSB accreditation, because that is an indication for you or to you that the school has a good faculty, has good reputation, has good programs, the employability of their graduates is high, and the overall quality of the school is good. That's very important for us as well, but also is important for our rankings, because no schools can be ranked if they're not ASCSB or EQUIS accredited. We have been doing pretty good last couple of years. The number at the bottom, which says Financial Times 2015 Global MBA Rankings, number one in Australia, 2 weeks ago. So we've been ranked over the last 2 years as the number one MBA program in Australia. Number 49 in the world, that's by The Economist in 2014. The new survey, which came before Christmas out, ranked us at number 28 in the world. So this first slide is more about to tell you that we are a relatively old business school. We are Tier 1 business school in Australia and globally. We are very international, measured by a number of students who are studying at the school, a number of alumni, and the countries where they live and work. And then we have approved, so we are a quality school, we are accredited, and we are ranked in top 100 business schools all over the world. I can tell you another number. I think this year, out of those 17,000 business schools, of which 1,200 of them are accredited, only 157 applied to be ranked by Financial Times. So competition is very strong, and I hope this is going to give you a good idea about the school we work for. Location, our base is in Sydney, which is a business hub, you know, of Australia. I think the Sydney economy contributes about 30% to the GDP of the whole country. It's top 10 financial centers. You know, leading international organizations have their head offices for Australia, New Zealand, or Asia Pacific in Sydney. Living standard is amongst the top in the world. It's a beautiful city. It's a safe city. And plenty of opportunities for international students in many ways. We also, our campus in Sydney is based on North Ryde, which is 15 kilometers from Sydney. I will just see if I have another. Yeah, I can show you here first. So this is a kind of a aerial picture of the campus. The buildings in the circle, that's the grounds of the Macquarie University. We are somewhere up to the left with this blue little rectangle. Our campus is there. We are 15 kilometers from the central CBD. We have a train station on the campus, so commuting is very easy. And if you're wondering about all those buildings inside and outside the circle, those are the head offices of a number of technology companies based at Macquarie Park. The whole park is basically one of the biggest, largest, if not the largest, technology park in the Southern Hemisphere, with more than 250 international organizations having their offices there, and they engaged in medical technology, biotechnology, IT, telecommunications, so on and so forth. And they've worked with Macquarie University on many projects in many areas, but they also work with MGSM on their management issues. And very often, their executives, they come to our premises to have their own, you know, off-site management sessions. Their staff are sent to us to learn management. And most importantly, I don't think there is a single entity there that doesn't have an alumni from MGSM, which helps us a lot once when it comes to jobs, internships, sponsorship of our projects, research projects, so on and so forth. So I'll just go back to the north, right? So that's our campus, as I said, purposely developed for management education. The campus is separated from the campus of the university, but our students enjoy all the facilities that the university is offering, including state-of-the-art library. We have a child care facility, a lot of on-campus accommodation, and we're just 15 kilometers from the Sydney CBD. We also have a CBD campus. A CBD campus is located in the center of the city, about 5 minutes walk from the Opera House and the Harbour Bridge, with a state-of-the-art facility for teaching. That's the place where our part-time students who work in the city, so from finance, from legal, from government institution, insurance, come to study in the evening. We also have a campus in Hong Kong, which is delivering the same program as we do and deliver at North Ryde and in the CBD. So our professors, they fly to Hong Kong and teach, and those opportunities are available for international students. So we only have MBA there, though. So those who are interested in having one unit in or two units in Hong Kong, they can do that as well. So in addition to our own campus, another distinctive feature and benefit of MGSM is that is our faculty. MGSM faculty are employed by MGSM. They don't teach undergraduate students. What they do most of the time is they teach, they do research, and they consult with the corporate world, which is critical for a business school. Because of that, they all possess a very diverse mix of academic expertise and corporate experience, and they have very strong contacts with the industry. And the major factor in the MGSM standing in the business community. I have here a list of some of the corporations that our faculty and MGSM have been in contact over the years. And as you can see, it's a small list. We have a lot more partners that we have been working or are working at the moment. But you can see the list of who's who in the Australian international corporate world. The students. This is a snapshot of our MBA cohort. In general, they're mature. They're about 30 years of age. International students are younger, 27, with significant work experience. They're coming from different industries and sectors, largely and mostly from banking and finance, retail, IT, engineering and construction. Recently, we have seen a lot of interest coming from the healthcare sector and pharmaceutical sector, and it's a trend in the domestic market, but we have also seen a lot of inquiries from the international candidates who have been working in the healthcare sector as well. And the job mix or functions are vary from sales and marketing, executive, general management, so on and so forth. As I said, students are very mature. I also have to say that MGSM has been ranked over the last 5-6 years by The Economist as one of the top three in the world. I think on three occasions we got ranked number one in the world for quality of our students, MBA students, that is measured by their age, work experience, and management experience. So it's very, very experienced classroom, which is important for international students as our teaching is based on the experiential methods. You learn in the classroom more from your colleagues than from the professors and the books. Alumni, as I mentioned, we have more than 16,000 of them across 135 countries. When they came to us, the part-time and full-time from international students, when they came to us, they were already, experts in their fields and in some cases managing their organizations. If you can imagine that they're all now very well plugged in within their own organizations, very often they're leaders of their organizations. And that's critical for MGSM because while they were studying here and the first couple of years post-graduations, MGSM supported them through that process. But once when they go into corporate world and establish themselves, they start returning the favor, if I can put it that way, and they do help us a lot in many, many areas. Once when you graduate from MGSM, you will become part of that global community of our alumni who are very much passionate about MGSM. In addition to our own campus, if I can put it that way, that is dedicated to management education and the faculty that is only teaching MGSM students and working with MGSM students, we have our own dedicated student services team. And student services team is critical because they're there for you to offer you an advice and anything else related, to your study, but they also help a lot once when you arrive to Australia and start studying with us with other things, they can give you a recommendation where to find accommodation, what's the best way to get from A to B. They will assist you in many, many areas that are important in addition to studying. They should be able to assist you with the accommodation, and they also organize the and run dedicated student web portal, organization of syndicate rooms, and they can help you with access to all the facilities at Macquarie University. More importantly, for you sitting in Mexico City, thinking of coming to Australia, studying MBA, and looking to stay here for a couple of years to gain international work experience, make some money to pay for your study, we have dedicated career services team. And it's a very experienced team of our colleagues who work jointly with external consultants on career guidance, on coaching and mentoring, and they also facilitate introduction to major corporates, recruiters, and influential search firms. They're very effective in doing this. The latest Financial Times survey, which is the one that was published 2 weeks ago, and you can find the information on their website, put 91% as a number of full-time MBA students that are employed within 3 months post-graduation, either in Australia or back home. We do understand that it is all about jobs. Our career services team, and not just career services, MGSM faculty, MGSM staff, we are all dedicated to our students, and we do help by providing advice and very often putting them in touch with our contacts in Sydney, in Australia, and overseas once they graduate and start looking for work. MBA program is basically, as I said, it's a top program in Australia at the moment. It's in number 56 in the world. It's comprises 16 units of MBA program, 10 of them core units and 6 elective units, and they're spread throughout 2 years. So it's a 2-year full-time program, where international students usually take 2 units per term. So if you're studying full-time, which is the program is 2-year full-time, and you want to apply for a post-study work visa, you have to study 2 units per term. you should be able to complete that in 2 years and in 8 terms. We run a program in terms, so instead of 2 semesters, we have 4 terms. And those terms start in January, April, June, and September. So which provides an additional flexibility to our part-time and full-time students and international students to enroll 4 times instead of twice or once in some occasions. In addition to MBA program, we also offer articulation part, which is available to our part-time domestic, and it's also available for international students. Very often we have inquiries from senior international managers who are managing organizations, but they don't have a university degree. And we provide that articulation path by putting them into postgraduate certificate first, from they can articulate to diploma and move into the MBA. So if you could see on the screen, these 4 units are certificate units. These 4 units are here part of the diploma, so if you continue with the diploma, you only need additional 4 units. And once when you complete the diploma, you can transfer those 8 units to MBA program, do additional 2 core units, and then select your electives. So here are the requirements for the program. We do expect our MBA students to have 2 years of managerial and professional experience. That's critical to participate in an MGSM MBA program, as all your colleagues that you're going to be studying with are experienced and knowledge. It's all about knowledge sharing, so to be able to learn from them and to be able to contribute to their learning process as well, you need to have that managerial and professional experience. Postgraduate diploma and postgraduate certificate are articulation parts. You don't have to have a university degree, but you will have to have 5 years relevant work experience and management experience to be able to enroll into that program. The core units are basically standard units offered by any business school, global good business school, covering accounting, marketing, financial management, operational management, and some good aspects of strategy, including strategic work frameworks and strategic management. And the core units can be elective units can be selected from a set of, I think, close to 40 now. Oh, it's over 40, covering leadership, strategy, marketing, HR management, financial strategy, logistic and operations management, global perspective, and entrepreneurship. On this slide here, we only listed 2 units per subset, but I think on average we offer between 5 and 7 units for each of these sub kind of specialization. If I can call them that way. In addition to Master of Management, to MBA, we offer Master of Management, and it's a new program. We launched in January last year. Currently, we have more than 65 students studying Master of Management, and the program is designed with the idea of basically providing management education to talent straight after the university. The program is very similar to an MBA, to our MBA program. It contains 8 core units, and it also has 6 elective units. The difference is these 2 units here, okay, which is professional experience units. So the idea is that once when you complete the first year and complete these core 8 units, you go and work with our faculty, our professors, and our corporate partners, equivalent of 2 units, or which I would say it's about 80, if not more, face-to-face units on practical issues and problems facing our partners. For example, if you for marketing, for practical experience related to marketing, you may go with our faculty to a company which has a partnership with the MGSM and work with people or employees of their company and most of the time management of the company on particular issues. Marketing area, you might be asked to develop marketing strategy for launch of a new product, and which is something that we did in the past with our students. The program is the same as MBA, so it's 2-year full-time post-study work visa eligible. Once when you complete the program, you're eligible to apply for post-study work visa afterwards and stay and gain international experience here in Australia. As I said, this industry experience or practical experience is designed for the students to get real industry experience through every core unit, not just through these 2 units of practical experience. And that will be achieved by, you know, working on live problems. You will have role plays, practice. A lot of case competition is designed by the faculty to get you to basically deal with issues that you will be facing in real world. The core units of a Master of Management are very similar to core units of MBA, and the elective units we're offering a little bit less than for MBA, but they cover more or less the same areas as MBA. The details of these units you can find on our website. Hopefully we're going to have a new website up and running next week, but all this information is already on our website. You can find more details there and in the brochures that should be available with the Guadalupe. What I wanted to say about Master of Management also is that it's a relatively new concept, actually. The whole idea is that to bring into our classroom those students who just finished university to come in and learn management in a very practical way. The idea is that MBA program is designed for those who have 10 years of work experience, who are 30 years old, they have family, they have kids, they have work, they have to learn management one way, which is based on a lot of practical work, a lot of cases, a lot of interaction between the students, whereby they can leverage their life experience and work experience. Master of Management is, we say then, why do you have to wait until you're 30 and to have all these burdens with you to learn management in an MBA style course when you can come and do early career Master of Management? You will learn the same body of knowledge as MBA, but you will learn in a different way. And if we give you 2 units or a couple of months of practical experience with our corporate partners, once when you finish Master of Management, you will not have to do an MBA afterwards. Once when you finish it, you will learn about management as much as our MBA students, and I'm pretty sure that will place you on a fairly steep learning and a career progression path, perhaps even steeper than MBA. If I can give you an example, perhaps. If I was a corporate executive in Australia and having to decide about employment of an MBA student from Mexico City or graduate who has 10 years of work experience, who's 35, has wife, kids, and everything with him, and pay him $150,000, have nice office assistant and everything else on one side, and on another side, I have a 24, 25 years old Master of Management graduate with no burden, younger, more enthusiastic, willing to work, who knows about management almost as much as an MBA student, and who's 30% or 30% cheaper. I would rather employ her than an MBA graduate from a, you know, a business perspective. So in terms of opportunities in the corporate world, I firmly believe that this master management program is a very attractive proposition. Furthermore, if you look at what's happening in the corporate world, where you know, even big organizations like GE, or I'm not talking about technology company, but all those guys like I don't know, Escondida Chile and BHP and big giants are talking about entrepreneurial boardroom and expecting new employees, young employees, to manage people, processes, money a lot earlier in their career. I think prospects for graduates in the Master of Management program are pretty good. How to apply? I think Guadalupe and team over there are going to help you a lot with that. But in principle, what you need to submit is an application form. You need to submit statement of personal aims and achievements, your CV, referee report, and you need to demonstrate English proficiency, which is IELTS and TOEFL of a certain level, which is published on our website, but Guadalupe should be able to tell you about that. You may notice that we don't ask for GMAT for MBA students and Master of Management students. That's purely because we as a school do not see or have not seen a correlation between success in the MBA course and the GMAT score. Our program is MBA program is very experiential. We are looking for students who have entrepreneurial spirit, who can think strategically, who enjoy challenges, who are able to stand and debate and discuss. And we are not sure if high GMAT score can reflect those characteristics and attributes of individuals who are studying at MGSM. Important dates. This is it's a little bit old presentation, but the dates are okay. We have a term 2 starting in April, term 3 starting on 27th of June, term 4 2016 is starting in September 2016, and you know, term 1 2017 is going to start in January. In general, in order for your applications to be processed, you will need to apply 6 weeks before the end of the term commences. The investment, the MBA program is $4,750 per course unit, which is brings it to $76,000 for the whole program. Master Management is $60,000. I believe that Macquarie University is offering bursary for nationals of the Latin American countries, which is $5,000 per year, with $10,000 for the duration of the course, but Guadalupe should be able to give you more information about this. We do have scholarships for international students, and we offer 4 of them. They're very competitive, but I will definitely encourage you to apply for the scholarships. In the end, I just want to summarize why MGSM. As I said at the beginning, we are a relatively autonomous business school with a faculty totally dedicated to our students who are delivering management educations at the campuses dedicated to MGSM. So facilities are not shared with undergraduates. It's a campus for management. We have a reputation and history established 45 years ago, which is fairly, you know, old for a business school, and consistently ranked as one of the top Australian MBA programs with a very strong alumni in Australia and globally. And we have one MBA program that is delivered in three locations. Definitely, I need to stress out the Hong Kong campus, which is a fantastic opportunity for Latin American students, and we've seen a lot of interest in this respect to go and do one or two units in Hong Kong, surrounded by students from Hong Kong, locals, Chinese, and expatriates. In addition to that, we offer a lot of elective programs that are international. One of them is a study tour in China, where you go and spend couple of weeks with our professor visiting companies in China, which will give you an additional kind of angle to your international experience. Our faculty, as I said, is highly qualified, experienced, so they're teachers, they're researchers, and they're consultants to the corporate world, and our quality of our students definitely ensures that you're going to learn a lot while studying at MGSM and working with them. And that concludes this part of the presentation. I would now hand it over to Guadalupe and those who are online who participated in this presentation to ask any questions that they may have.
Okay, thank you, Ross. So now it's time for see if someone have any question. Entonces, por favor, si quisieran anotar sus preguntas en el chat, pueden ser libres como de hacerlo en este momento para poder pasarlas a Ross. Okay, Ross, is it possible to explain a little more about scholarships? Maybe the amounts?
Yeah, well, I can, it's general about finance. I know it's that's always an issue for students coming to Australia. Fortunately, the Australian dollar is going down big time. A couple of weeks ago, I was comparing prices of U.S. schools, top schools that are in top 100 in Financial Times and MGSM, and in Australian dollars, I mean, we are huge bargain. I must say that we are a lot cheaper than many of those schools. We're even cheaper than the schools who are not in top FT 100. But that's on a relative basis. In absolute terms, you know, Sydney is not an inexpensive place. But it's, as I said, with a decline in dollar, Australian dollar, it's not as it used to be. The one scholarship that is offered and that is valid until the end of 2016 is this bursary from Macquarie University that is available to all nationals of Latin American countries. So the university is basically providing a discount of $10,000 per course. So MBA is going to cost $66,000, Master of Management is going to cost $50,000 over the period of 2 years, which, you know, brings it down to $40,000 US dollars or $20,000 US dollars per year for a full-time MBA. and full-time master of management, early career master of management, with an opportunity to apply for post-study work visa and work in Australia. Excuse me, I'm in a meeting. Can I call you back? Who's on the line? Who's on the line? Okay, I'll call you back. Cheers, bye. It's a very good value proposition. And as I said, Sydney is expensive, but at the same time, Sydney is the top city in Australia and probably on this side of the world. There are plenty of work opportunities. Students, both MBA and Master of Management, if they're on full-time student visa, they can work. They can work 20 hours per week for the duration of the course. If they have a partner or they're married, their partners can work full-time while they're studying. And if they decide to stay in Australia for a couple of years and obtain that work experience, their partners can work as well, which, you know, they should be able to, while working here and staying in Australia for a couple of years, to pay off for their studies. We have 4 scholarships available, and I do encourage everyone. We offer 4 scholarships per term, so in total 16. They are up to 25% of the value of the program. And I must stress, they are very competitive.
Okay, great. Thank you. Yeah.
Another thing I just want to add, in terms of part-time work, as I said, we are based on this Quarry Park area, which is home to a number of international organizations. The whole area is growing. There is one of the biggest shopping centers in Australia a walking distance from our campus, from our premises. A lot of our students find part-time jobs there as well. Accommodation is available on the campus, and MGSM students can participate in it. And there is also plenty of accommodation in Chatswood, which is 7-8 kilometers away from here as well, and it's relatively affordable.
Okay, thank you. We have some more questions. The other is about the Master of Social Entrepreneurship. Is it possible to know more about this program?
Yes. The program actually jointly run Macquarie University. MGSM delivers. MGSM does 4 units, and Macquarie University provides the rest.
Okay.
The 4 subjects, and they can choose electives. We haven't seen a lot of interest. The program is very interesting. For some reason, I don't know, after the financial crisis, the drive for socially entrepreneurial kind of ventures have slightly, have not almost disappeared, but has definitely subsided. And also, personally, as a, you know, I spent 20 years in banking. Maybe I'm biased, but I don't see the difference between management of socially responsible enterprises or socially responsible initiatives and running the business. In my view, managers of organizations should run any business on a socially responsible basis and take care about community, environment, and everything else. And I think the trend globally is changing. So from that perspective, you know, an MBA program with a few electives on the taken from a social entrepreneurial space would perhaps for me be a better option than a social entrepreneurship, mastering social entrepreneurship. Hello?
Yes, okay, Ross, thank you. And we have another question, and it says, is it possible to apply for a Master of Management if I have 2 years since I finished my bachelor degree and I do not have enough professional experience?
Yes, it's possible, but we need to see, you know, how that person, how old is the person or candidate? What is it that they did in the past? Level of their experience, in principle, yes, but we don't want them to be 28 years old or with 5 years of work experience. If they're 23, 4 to 5 with 1 or 2 years of work experience to get in and do master management, yes.
Okay, perfect. And another question says, hello, my name is Arturo, and I would like to know about the payment process. Have we to pay in one exhibition, or there could be a scheme of payments?
For the whole course. It's changed.
Okay, the I had to consult with the colleagues. They would have to pay upfront a certain percentage, which I just need to confirm. I was under the impression that that initial payment is 30%, but Guadalupe, it's very much the same for the whole university as well. So you might be able to help with this one. The information I was given by my colleague, which is new, international students have to pay 50% in advance, and they continue paying per unit as they progress. So if we're talking about international student, they will have to pay 50% in advance. They will get the credit from Macquarie University bursary, and then they will be paying as they go. So two units per term, the 50% of the cost of the unit until they graduate. But I'll get the confirmation. So the latest information is 50% upfront.
Okay, yes, thank you, yes, you're right. And, well, I think those are all the questions. I only have to mention something about the scholarships, talking about the specific organizations here in Mexico. So I think it's better I explain it in Spanish, Ross, if you
permit to me. Just a correction.
Yeah.
Okay. I just got the fees. Okay. What's payable? In advance, it's 50% of the annual full-time course.
Yes, so exactly. It's the first semester or of the course.
Yes, for the first year. Mm-hmm. For the first year. Not 76. It's not 38,000. It's half of it. So it's 19.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay, right. So I'm going to explain in Spanish the part of the Mexican scholarships.
Okay.
So just very fast. Nosotros tenemos, bueno, Macquarie University tiene convenio con varios organismos que ofrecen becas aquí en México. Uno de ellos es FUNET, que es un organismo que se encarga de ofrecer financiamientos estudiantiles. El otro organismo es CONACYT. Entonces, para los que no hayan escuchado de FUNET, este organismo se enfoca a apoyar a áreas económico-administrativas, cosa que pues CONACYT es más como de áreas tecnologías y ciencia, pero hay un convenio específico que existe entre FUNED y CONACYT. Entonces, de hecho, en este momento se encuentra activa, se encuentra vigente la convocatoria y ustedes pueden aplicar a esta beca, a esta convocatoria de FUNED en conjunto con CONACYT para los programas de management y obtendrían, como tienen convenio con la Universidad de Macquarie, obtendrían un 25% de beca por parte de Macquarie University y el resto, que sume hasta máximo un 80% aproximadamente, el resto lo otorgaría la convocatoria FUNED CONACYT. Una parte como que la financia FUNED y la otra parte la otorga directamente CONACYT. Adicional a esto, hay una beca también que otorga la Universidad de Macquarie a latinoamericanos. Esta se otorga indistintamente a cualquier persona por el solo hecho de haber aplicado a la universidad y obtener una carta de oferta. Y esta beca consiste en $5,000 de descuento sobre su colegiatura por año. Y se puede sumar esta beca con alguna a la que apliquen desde aquí de México o alguna de las que también mencionó Ross, que ofrece la universidad, se pueden sumar. Entonces pueden llevarse, pues sí, prácticamente el, ¿cómo se dice? Pues sí, la colegiatura completa o llevarse el mayor apoyo posible. Ok. And I think yes, is everything. There is not more questions. And also just for clarify the part of the fees in also I want to tell them in Spanish. And como mencionaba Ross, se paga para poder inscribirse, el primer pago que se realiza es el del primer semestre o una cuota un poco menor. Eso depende también como un poquito de la universidad. Entonces, aproximadamente el semestre está como de unos 15 a 19 mil dólares. Entonces, ese es el primer pago que se hace. Y ya estando allá, pueden ustedes ya sea realizar los pagos por materia, como mencionaba Ross, o semestralmente. Y listo. Ok, Ross, I think is all. There are no more questions, I think.
Okay, Guadalupe. Thank you very much for arranging this for us. I would like to thank you on behalf of MGSN and my colleague Ivana and Diana for attending this webinar. And yeah, we are looking forward to any new questions that you may have and perhaps seeing you on the campus in the near future. Best of luck from Sydney, and thank you very much again.
Thank you very much, Ross, and thank you to all the participants of this webinar. So we also hope to see you soon here in Mexico. Y muchas gracias a todos por haber atendido este webinar. Por favor, para que tengan mayor asesoramiento sobre pues todo el proceso de aplicación y en qué consiste en los programas específicos del MGSM o de la Universidad de Macquarie, pues se pueden acercar a nosotros. Somos LAE, Latino Australia Education, y pues los asesoramos absolutamente en todo lo que conlleva el proceso de aplicación con la escuela. Vamos encaminándolos en el paso a paso. Entonces, pueden contactarnos en nuestra oficina en la Ciudad de México. Nuestros teléfonos son 5250-5170 o 5250-0179 o pueden escribir al correo mexicocity@latinoaustralia.com. Muchas gracias por su atención y esperamos pues saber de ustedes pronto. Que tengan muy buena noche. Thank you very much, Ross. Have a good day.
Okay, thank you. Keep in touch.
Yep, of course. Bye-bye.
Bye.